Hello, my name is Tim Gutowski. I'm a professor of mechanical engineering at MIT, and I understand you're now engaged in a course of study to learn about the environmental assessment of products and engineering goods and services. So I thought I'd just start and say I got interested in that about 18 years ago, and I've been studying that ever since. And I encourage you in your studies. I think this is a great area. We need attention, and I think it's a good direction for engineering students to take. In this very short video, I just want to introduce a elementary concept that would be a good place for you to start. It's called eco-efficiency. And very plainly, what we try to do is balance these sort of services provided by a product, or it could be actually a service, it could be selling insurance, or it could be an automobile. It's a quite flexible idea. And then you can normalize that by the environmental harm, right? So this is something you want to maximize. You want to provide useful services to humanity, and you want to minimize environmental harm. Quite easy idea. I think one thing that's appealing to engineers is that it's amenable to analysis using engineering tools. The engineering impact, for example, or the environmental impact could be energy, and you could use thermodynamic principles to analyze the energy, and we do often. But I think you'll shortly learn that you want to open that up a little bit, and what you're really going to want to do is a life cycle assessment of the product. So you're going to want to look much more broadly over the whole life of this product, from when it's extracted to when it meets its end of life, whatever that might be, landfill or recycling, incineration, reuse, any one of a number of ideas. And then you'll use that as the, or generally use that as the normalization factor. So that's a good, good place to start. I wish you success in your study. But I want to put this in perspective. You're at the beginning, and I want to tell you that the eco-efficiency idea and the life cycle assessment idea are your basic fundamentals, and you need to get that down solidly. And then there's more steps beyond that, yes? Because it becomes complicated when you invent a new product, you intend to solve a particular problem, and then it goes out in the world and it may be used, or it might be subject to market forces that you hadn't anticipated. So I just want to give you a hint of where this field, you could call it engineering for sustainability, where it's headed. And so little by little, I think you'll be exposed in your coursework as we open up the box a little bit wider and you see all the wonderful challenges that lie before us in doing this analysis. So I wish you good luck.